Welcome to week 7 of this course. Let's again take a look at the PV system design overview. In the previous weeks, we have discussed many of the essential steps in PV system design. We looked into location-related issues and the PV modules. We have discussed how the fluid dynamic model takes into account the temperature and the irradiance effect to accurately predict the DC side yield of a PV module. In the last 2 weeks, the balance of system components such as charge controllers, converters, and inverters were discussed as they are essential for an optimal operation of a PV system. In this week, we will consider all these aspects of PV system design to accurately predict the energy yield of a PV system. This week, we will introduce multiple step-by-step approaches to design your very own PV system. We will start with a general introduction to PV system design, followed by simple and complex approaches to the design of standalone and grid-connected PV systems. This video serves as a basic introduction to a practical PV system design process. As seen in the previous weeks, PV systems comprise the PV panels, balance of system components, such as charge controller, inverter, battery, cables, converters, mounting frames, and the outputs. In particular, we have learned in detail how the different components in PV system operate with respect to one or another. Basically, depending on the application, we have to use these components to design and build a complete PV system. There are different types of PV systems, of course. They can be classified in standalone PV systems and grid-connected PV systems. Each of those categories might be further divided into several subcategories. A standalone PV system relies only on solar power, since it is not connected to the distribution grid. It contains a storage system, such as batteries, to store the unused solar energy. Standalone PV systems are usually installed in remote areas where the grid is absent. Typical components in a standalone PV system include the PV panels, both DC and AC loads, the inverter that is connected to the AC loads, and the charge controllers. On the other hand, grid-connected PV systems have the distribution grid as a backup and are typically installed in buildings. They consist of the PV panels, the AC loads, and the inverter that connects the AC loads and the PV panels. Now it is time to look at how all the components are designed and brought together to create a complete PV system. We can design a PV system at different levels of complexity. Based on time and other resources available, there are two design strategies that can be employed. The first is the simple design strategy of a PV system. The simple design strategy is based on very simple assumptions and does not take any weather-dependent changes into account. It is quick and easy to work with and can be executed using a simple spreadsheet application. In such a design approach, the performance of the PV modules and the other components are determined by considering only their standard test condition, STC, values, and the equivalent sun hour, or ESH, at PV system's location. This strategy is normally used to create a first approximation of a PV system design. The second type of PV system design is the complex design approach. After a first approximation of the design obtained from the previous strategy, a detailed analysis of the PV system performance can be carried out using this system strategy. In this respect, the location-dependent variable irradiance and weather conditions, the profile of the loads, and the other inputs are used to obtain the time-dependent performance characteristics of the PV system. To this end, we are going to put together all models, tools, and steps learned in previous weeks of this course. By using this strategy, a PV system design close to the reality can be achieved, albeit, to execute it, a programming language such as MATLAB needs to be used. To conclude, in this week you are going to learn about simple and complex design strategies. You will study how to implement these strategies for both standalone PV system and grid-connected system. In the next video, we will begin with a simple design strategy.